Good morning, dear students. Today we will start next point, that is see the chemical properties. Already some chemical properties we discussed: reaction with oxygen, reaction with water, metals and non-metals, how they react with oxygen, and you wrote maybe some examples also. Okay, so this last time we discussed about the reaction with water, how the metals are react with water, and some experiment also we saw. Okay, so today what we will see reaction with water. Now whenever the non-metals, see, mostly non-metals are not react with water. This is the first important things. Non-metals do not react with water. But in this non-metals, do you know the reactivity series? Okay, this reactivity series is very important when we are learning this chemical properties. Okay, so just today again you write down that reactivity series, and if it is possible then you recite that all the reactivity series as well as the symbol of that particular element, means metal or non-metal. Okay, so here see the reaction with water. Non-metals do not react with water. See, metals react with water, and that you know that they form a hydroxides. Okay, oxides also, and hydrogen gas is released, means this last time we discussed about that. So in this, non-metals do not react with water, but one non-metal, that is the phosphorus. See, phosphorus is very reactive non-metal. See, mostly the non-metals are not reactive, but the phosphorus is very reactive non-metal. But when, see, phosphorus is very reactive non-metal when exposed to air, means when the phosphorus is come contact with air, then it will react very fastly. Okay, it will, see, it catch fire immediately. So because of that, the phosphorus is stored in water. See, why phosphorus is stored in water? Because non-metals do not react with water, see, or steam. This is the very important, this lesson is very important for you, because this the lesson is there in 10th standard also, but in that in detail you will see. So because of that you should know these all the points. Metals are react with water, and non-metals do not react with water. But in that non-metal, one non-metal, that is the phosphorus, is very reactive metal. But when it come contact with the air, okay? So because of that, and it catch the fire, and because of that, this phosphorus is stored in water. Okay, do you understand this point? See, only just remember, non-metals do not react with water. Okay, and because of this reason, the phosphorus, which is very reactive, that is stored in a water. Okay, now the next chemical property that we will learn, that is the reaction with acid, means how metals are react with acids. That point we will see. Whenever the metal, means magnesium, aluminium, okay, any metal you take, that all the metals, when they react with what acid, they form a salt and hydrogen gas is released. Okay, so here are some examples. I given here one example. See, metals react with acid to form their respective salts and hydrogen gas. See, you know that. Now this salts means what? See, do you remember zinc sulfate? Okay, so many it is we use, copper sulfate, okay, ferrous sulfate, it is there in chemistry lab, and you know also that copper sulfate color is blue. Okay, these all are the salts, means how they produce, because when the metals react with acids. Okay, see, now how they form? When the metals react with acids, that time the salt form and hydrogen gas is released. Okay, so here one example is given, that is the zinc, Zn. What is the symbol of zinc? Zn. Zinc react with H2SO4. H2SO4 means base acid, sulfuric acid. It is, see, mostly commonly how many acids are used? Three acids are very important. That is, first one is a sulfuric acid, second one is hydrochloric acid, and third one is, who will tell me? Just remember, third one is which one? See, okay, just remind it, okay, and you tell me afterwards. First one, sulfuric acid. So sulfuric acid is known as a king of acid, okay. Sulfuric acid is known as a king of acid. So when they saying react with acid H2SO4, it form ZnSO4. ZnSO4 means zinc sulfate, and hydrogen gas is released. Now whenever the hydrogen gas is released, how we identified this hydrogen gas? Because it produces a pop sound, okay. So because of that we can identify it is hydrogen gas is released. So Zn plus H2SO4, it gives ZnSO4 plus H2, okay. One more example we will see. First write these all the points in your notebook, okay. See what we were discussing? Reaction with acids. Okay? So example we will see. So first what zinc completed, okay? Now we will take Mg. Mg means what? Who will tell me Mg means what? Magnesium. Okay? Mg plus H2SO4. H2SO4 means hydrochloric acid. And what it will the product? Tell me what product will form. You know that when metal is react with it acid, it form a salt and hydrogen gas is released. So this Mg will react with SO4 and this H2 gas will be released. So what will be the product? Mg SO4 plus H2. Okay, understood how it is raised? The yeast will react with SO4 and hydrogen yeast gas will release right time. Okay, write down the name downside. Means whenever you will do the study afterwards, so that time you will know what it is. Okay, this is a magnesium, this is which acid? Sulfuric acid. This is magnesium sulfate and this one is hydrogen gas. Okay. Now one more that we will take, see. Now magnesium. Okay. Magnesium react with this. Which acid is this? Who will tell me? Hydrochloric acid. Okay. HCl means which acid? Hydrochloric acid. Okay. Tell me now which product will form first. Okay, you have to do it fast. Now Mg plus HCl. Now Mg will react with whom? See, you know that whenever the metals react with two acids, it forms salt and hydrogen gas. So this Mg will react with Cl. Okay, Mg plus HCl minus. Okay, so Mg will react with Cl and this hydrogen gas will release. So MgCl2 magnesium chloride and plus hydrogen gas is released. Okay, Mg means what? Magnesium. HCl is hydrochloric acid, magnesium chloride and H2. Now see here, Cl is 1 but here 2. So this is the balance reaction? No. So we have to balance it. How you will balance this reaction? See here, chlorine to chlorine and here only 1. So we'll give here 1. But now see, hydrogen also 2. Here hydrogen, 2H2 gas is released. Okay. So this is the another example. Okay. Like this way, you write at least 5 examples today. Now these 3 examples we discussed, you write at least 5 examples. Take different iron you take, iron how it react with that. Okay, so now next point we will see, that is the reaction with base. Write this all the points, okay? Okay, see, we will see the next point, that is reaction with bases. So when metals are react with base, the same whatever when the metals react with acid, the salt and hydrogen gas form the same way when metals react with base to form their respective salt and hydrogen gas, respective salt and hydrogen gas. See here one example I given, that is the air. Air means what? Aluminium react with NaOH. Now base means mostly the OH group is present. See, in 7th standard acid, base and salt, that lesson we discuss about that. Okay, acid means what? H plus ion, and base in that what? OH minus ions means hydroxide group is present, so it is a basic in nature. So NaOH means what? Sodium hydroxide. Okay, when this aluminium react with sodium hydroxide in water, it forms sodium aluminate, that is NaAlO2, it is sodium aluminate and hydrogen gas. So these two when salt and hydrogen gas is formed. Okay, so MgOH twice, magnesium hydroxide, this is also base, NaOH is base. Okay, so whenever the hydroxide group, that all are the bases. So this is the reaction with bases. Now see the one question which is there in your mind, why madam it is written here 2, 2, 2 and 3? Because to balance this reaction, see, one separate video I am going to prepare, in that the balancing equation, how to balance the reactions, that we will see in the last. First we will complete this whole lesson and then we will see how to balance the reactions. Okay, so some students might have, they are knowing that IIT class students, they know how to balance the reaction. Just now you try to do it. We will see in the next lecture when this lesson will finish, one separately how to balance the reaction, that we will see. Okay, so these all the points you write down, and today your homework is write 5 examples of each, means reaction with acids and reaction with base. Write 5 examples. In that examples, try to write reaction. Okay, reactions are very important. So today, and read this point, it is there in your textbook, and some activities are given in your textbook, that activities we will learn in next period. Okay, thank you.